Hey VC, how's it going? Right, okay, a very quick video. I just want to show a handful of records I've been listening to over the last week or so. It's all reggae. I mentioned before that a local record shop had bought a large reggae collection, and everything in it was pretty much Nia Mint, and that's, you know, that's real Nia Mint as opposed to reggae mint, you know. So and just prior to that, I'd had a bit of a thin out of my own collection, and I'd flipped quite a bit of stuff. So with the cash from that, I bought quite a bit of reggae. So I thought I'd start showing some of that. So, but these records, stuff that I've had on the, I say, on the turntable over the last couple of weeks. And yeah, so I'll show you what I've been listening. So first of all, this is what I listen to in the background. This is Dennis Bavell and the Brain Damage album, 1981. This is actually on Fontana Records, which isn't necessarily a label that you'd associate with early 80s reggae, but yeah, so obviously Dennis Bavell, a bit of a UK reggae legend, responsible for so many great Lovers Rock tunes. But yeah, but I mean, this is a nice album. It's there's two discs. The first album is the standard album, and there's an additional dub release with it. Now the dub album for me is much better than the actual album. So, but yeah, really nice stuff. Hopefully you can hear a little bit of that. So cool. Right, okay. So some of the stuff that I've been picking up. I'm gonna start off with a 12 inch. This is Keith Rowe and Groovy Situation. As you can see, it's on the Black Swan label. Came out in 1977, produced by Lee Perry. I first heard this record on the Arcology box set, the Lee Perry compilation. If you don't have that that comp, it's certainly worth looking out for, and it's pretty cheap now. It's three CDs, and it, yeah, it's just a brilliant compilation. But yeah, but for me, this was one of the highlights of that set. Yeah, I mean, first of all, it's a great vocal, but the tune itself, it's so catchy. It's one of these songs that gets stuck in your head. You know, you find yourself singing it a few days later, so I'll perhaps do a needle drop on that, so very nice. Right, okay, a couple of Johnny Clark albums. So first up, perhaps one of his better known records, this is Enter Into His Gates With Praise from 1975 on the Attack label. So there you go. I love the Attack label. I just love the look of it. Probably aesthetically, probably my favourite label, I'd say. But yeah, I love this sleeve as well. It's a shame it's got this little tear on the front there, but the sleeve's intact and that image is great. It's repeated on the back there. But yeah, but this is an interesting album. So it's Johnny Clark and the Aggravators, produced by Bunny Lee, mixed by King Tubby. But it's an interesting listen because, you know, just looking at the first side, it kicks off with four absolutely killer roots reggae tracks, and then it finishes the side with three ballads. Now there aren't many reggae artists that can get away with doing that as convincingly as Johnny Clark can, and that's mainly because he can just sing any style of reggae music and it always sounds good. But yeah, a nice record. But the Johnny Clark album that I've been listening to a lot recently is this. This is from 1980. This is originally Mr. Clark, and this is on the Clock Tower label. Now, this is just a full-on roots reggae album. I think partly cut in Jamaica, partly cut in New York. But yeah, an album that I'd never heard before. I didn't know anything about. And I think it's fair to say that this is my find of the year. Obviously, it's not a new record, it's not a reissue, but of all the stuff that I bought, this is the one that's hogged the turntable the most, I would say. So yeah, lovely stuff. And it's just, I think it's the horns, actually, on this record. Obviously, the vocal's wonderful, but that goes without saying. But the horn sound on this record, it's so bright, so positive. It's just a really uplifting sound. So, yeah, definitely recommend that if you don't know it. Right, and just a couple more. An album that I've been playing a lot this week is Tony Tuff's self-titled album from 1980. This is produced by Yabba Yu, Vivian Jackson. And again, it's the vocals. Actually, all of these records, it's certainly the vocals that that make them all. It's interesting, actually, because I look at my record collection and it really is just a whole lot of escapism. You know, there's not necessarily a great amount of depth there, but perhaps that says something about me, I don't know. But yeah, that's the sort of music I like, whether it be soul music, the sort of reggae that I got into first, that sort of reggae pop sound, that sort of goes hand in hand with that soul sound, that sort of groovy jazz sound, or even the rock music I listen to, you know. But all of this is roots reggae, And I don't think you can call this escapism, really. You know, it's quite the opposite. But the thing that links it all so well is the vocals, you know, the beautiful, soulful vocals that sit over the top of the music. And I think that's what drew me in initially. And this is an example of that. The track that I'm going to do a needle drop on is a second track, a track called Jar Almighty, written by Vivian Jackson. And again, it's just the harmonies. I think the whole song is sung in harmony. The voices on there, you've got Tony Tuff, but also Yabba Yu himself and Michael Prophet. And yeah, that's the pick of the bunch for this album for me anyway. So, right, and finally, talking about great vocalists, certainly great reggae vocalists, you've got to talk about Horace Andy. This is his album, I think from 1979, 1980, Natty Dread, Away She Want, produced by Tapazuki. Now, you just look at the lineup on here, Sly and Robbie, Ansel Collins on organ, Gladson Anderson on piano, then you've got like Sir Vin Gordon on horns, but also engineered by Scientist and Prince Jammy. An album, if I'm totally honest, I didn't know anything about prior to picking it up. I know quite a few of his records, but this is one, I don't know, it perhaps seems to go under the radar a little bit, I don't know. But I'll do a needle drop on this as well. Again, it's just got that lightness to it. Yeah, that, you know, that uplifting feel, you know, it's a really nice record. And again, one that I've been going back to quite a bit over the last couple of months. And that's on the New Star label. So, cheers.
Some things happen to me. Have mercy, please.
Many tried to take her away.